जिसमें संकीर्तना महाप्रभु
श्री गुरु ग्राम So in this way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he is talking about Urid Adiruda, that and the Dharuka, that with the Mahishyas, they both have Rudabhava and Adirudabhava. There are two kinds of Arir or Rudabhava. First is in the meeting time Mila and Madan, and the separation time is Mohan. There are two kinds of Bhed and Mohan. So accepting Gauri Vaishnava and other sampradaya, so who was the following in the lineage of Mahaprabhu Dhara, they can only realize, and other sampradaya they cannot realize. What we just kya gurde kya realize kar sakte hain kya realize
ye chitra jalwa aaj ki katha mein udharna aadi ka jo maan ka sab bhagavat mein hai kintu
The Sandho Vipralamba Kathas only can understand by the lineage of the Mahaprabhu. So Mahaprabhu, glorified all these the Katha by the Sanatana Goswami Pad. That's why I was saying, who are in the lineage of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can only understand this. If other Sampradaya will speak that Katha, so you cannot understand that. Because all this deep subject, Madanakya Mahabhava and other Bhava, you cannot get in any other Sampradaya. That's why it is saying. There are two Veds of Mohan, Dhruna and Chitravedu. There are 10 kinds of. In the Srimad Bhagavatam, Sukhdev Goswami Pad, so he is saying this Chitra Jalpa Katha. Jalpa, Jalpa, Sujalpa, Nijalpa, Vijalpa, etc. All these Divyan Madasha is manifest in the Srimati Radhika is completely, because sometimes the separation Radhika Rani is thinking about Krishna.
राधिकारी
Look here in the Braj Radhika and other gopis, they Purrag, Man Prabhag, all the things were showing in them. And the Prema Vachitra in the condition of Prema Vachitra in the Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto. So there is a little bit speciality of Maishi's love. Srila Gurudev. So he was reciting a shloka of Maishi's Prema. Just like Krishna, when from Dwarka to Hastinapur he was going, from Dwarka to Hastinapur. So all that time, all the Maheshiniya, Satyabhama, Rukmani and others, in the separation of Krishna, so how they are expressing their mood. Hey Sakhi, look at this glory. Whole night
Krishna ki jani apne pati ke virah mein kaise ho taraf
hai. She is so much agonized in the separation of her husband. Glory is a bird. At the night time you will see that there are two pairs. They cannot live each together in the night time. Glory is a word pair. It is mentioned in the scriptures. These kinds of words, Ullari, glory, glory. Other words pair is glory. So they cannot live in the night. In the night time, they cannot live together. You mad? Glory. Urari Pakshi, Urari words is a pair of words. They can words, word, B-I-R-D.
Bird, yes.
I am telling word. It's not bird. So they are, doing the night kirtan. So all these Mahishyas are, agonizing in the mode of separation of Krishna. Just like I told you about the story of Prem Sarovar, at once. At the bank of Prem Sarovar, Krishna himself, and Radha is sitting on the lap of Krishna there. And Krishna is combing on her hair that time. So at the time, there was a black bee came, and black bee came there, and he was thinking, this is the feet of Radharani is a lotus. He was thinking the feet of Radharani is just like lotus. So thinking that the feet of Radharani is just like a lotus, so he was always trying to sit on that. So he was trying to sit on the face of Srimati Radhika Rani. So Radhaji, what Radhaji is doing? She was so much afraid from that black bee. So by their Anchal, so she was, removing that black bee again and again. So because Krishna is taking darshan of Radhaji's beauty face, So what Krishna did? Oh, Bhakta, Bhakta, Bhakta. Another one, you need. Krishna was removing that black bee. Arey, one hata diya. Krishna was removing that black bee again and again. Bye. So what Krishna did? By the stick, he removed that. Remove that black bee. So he said that Madhusudan had went away. He won't come back. So Madhumangal saying Madhusudan. Madhumangal is saying Madhusudan is two types of meaning of Madhusudan. First is Krishna. One is Krishna and the second is Brahmar, black bee. So Madhusudan, who is taking the juice of flower. So Madhusudan is another name of black bee. And Krishna is another name. Who destroy this word is called Madhusudan. So that's why Krishna is another name is Madhusudan. So he killed the demons Madhusudan, that's why his name is Madhusudan. Hello.
Oh.
So what Radha is thinking that time? Madhumangal saying that Madhusudan went away. Madhusudan saying that that black bee is went away. Madhusudan is black bee. So black bee is another name is Madhusudan. So Madhumangal saying, oh, that black bee have went away, so he won't come back. But Radha is thinking. So what she is thinking that Madhusudan, Krishna has went away. Krishna has went away and leaving me, and he won't come back. So look. So Radha ji herself, she is sitting on the lap of Krishna, and Krishna is combing her hair. But Radha ji, she got the vipralama bhav that time, that separation mode, that oh, Madhusudan has left me, and she's saying, "Ha Krishna, Ha Krishna, where are you?" And Radha ji got fainted that time, and Krishna was so much shocked that time that she is sitting beside me on my lap, and still. Just what are the bhav she have, what kind of feelings she have. So Krishna said, what is the reason behind that Krishna from going to Vrindavan to Mathura? This is the special reason, because Krishna was thinking, I'm staying with Radharani and other gopis. That's in the Udmadasha, in the bhav she got, that I'm not with her. At that time, the things like that, when I am staying with them, present practically, but still they think that I am not there. So she has this kinds of stage of love. So Radhaji is thinking, when I am with her, Radhaji was thinking that I am not, with her this time. In the mode of separation, all the gopis left food, eating food. Krishna is saying, wherever she saw the black colors, like Krishna's color, so Radha is thinking that he is the Krishna. When she see the Katamal Vraksha, she is thinking that this is the Krishna. And she used to hug them. When she saw the black cloud, it's a black. And Radha is saying, oh, he is Krishna, and Krishna is going. And she is chasing that cloud, going mad. Madly she is chasing that cloud. She has left everything. So that's why Krishna is thinking, if I, meantime, if I go away from the gopis, so... So they will think about me and remember about me, and when they will remember and thinking about me, then they will get me. So that's why Krishna, so this was the special cause. This was a special cause, our Acharya Pas says, especially that at the Prem Sarovar story, I told you about in a is shortly. So at that time Radha ji was saying Ha Krishna, Ha Krishna. Krishna was giving sympathy to Radharani, but Radha ji was not listening anything. She was not in the consciousness that time. At that time, so Krishna himself, he is so much rolling on. She was so much agonized in the feel so much separation of Radha ji that time. So that's katha we are hearing, the Prem Sarovar. What that Sarovar is, what that pond is. So the Prem Sarovar is that pond water is coming from the tears of Srimati Radharani's eyes. And this is the form of separation mode. This is called the Prem Parivachitta. Even he described and the Dwarika. So the Mahishi is love. But if we think practically that which one is the topmost Prem Vachitra is this Viraj. You will see that love in the Braj only. So this is the mode of separation in the Braj. You will find that what is the love, what is love or Prem, you will find in the Braj. And Krishna saw everything practically with his eyes. So he wanted to realize that what is inside the heart of Srimati Radhika Rani, Radhika ji. What kind of love she has towards me? What kind of love she has towards me? I cannot taste the Prem Madhurya of Srimati Radhika. Just like Swarup Damodar writing a shlok. Three reasons that why Krishna again in this Kali Yuga he came into the form of Gauranga, especially Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Angakanti. He took the complexion and bhava of Radharani. Why Krishna took these two things? What? So he wanted to taste what is the Prem Madhur of Srimati Radhika Rani. He wanted to taste that. So how Radhika Rani always tastes the Prem Madhur of Sri Krishna? So Krishna is thinking himself, what is my Sondare that I cannot taste myself? I cannot, what is my sweetness? I cannot realize that. I cannot taste that. We cannot see our face. But we can see others' face. But our mouth, our face, our nose, our eyes, our ears, we cannot see. So we cannot see our beauty. So that's why Krishna is thinking that Radha ji, what is my sweetness? Radha Rani is listening, licking by her eyes, and she is relishing and tasting. And what kind of pleasure she gets in her heart after licking the sweetness of mine. So for tasting three of on these things of Radhika ji, he came down on this earth in the form of Gauranga Hari. Hari Bol, Dhanvat Maharaj. Madhav Maharaj ji ki ja. Then Mahaprabhu, he's talking about the. We have heard about this. How many kinds of Nayak heroes? Six kinds of Nayas. And there are 360 kinds of Naikas, heroines. So Naika Shiromani Radha Thakurani. So the topmost heroine is Radha Thakurani. And Radha Rani is Prem Madhure. Is describing here. So Mahaprabhu himself, he is talking about Mahaprabhu, he is talking about the Radharani. It's very nicely described here. If you take one word, in the Chaitanya, it is briefly described in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, Twenty Parichheda. First he is saying to Devi to Radha ji. There are two meanings of Devi. First, the beauty and Madhurya, the sweetness of Radha Rani is incredible, Anupam. And the sweetness and the beautifulness of Srimati Radhika is incredible. We cannot compare with anyone else. And the second meaning of Devi is the another meanings of Devi. From her, all the body parts from toe to head, from the hair of the hairs of the head, so it's beautiful, it's incredible. From toe to hair, she is beautiful. And Krishna is doing Leela, and Krishna is playing with all the body parts of Radhika. Just like in the town, there are many kinds of very kinds of leelas are putting there, holding there. In the town, there are many kinds of cities peoples. So they have so many kinds of entertainments. In the same way, Krishna, Srimati Radhika, every parts of Srimati Radhika Rani's body, it is a blast gear. It's the enjoyment field of Radhika Krishna. So Krishna himself is playing with all that parts. So there are many kinds of bhava describing of Radhika Rani. Very nicely described here, step by step. Radha Rani's half bhava and everything. All give the enjoyment to Krishna. Hare Gipta Mahadev. Hare. Gaura Prima Anande Hari Hari Bo Jai Shrila Gurudev Ki Jai Shrila Maharaj Ki Jai Jai Kar Ho. So we don't have enough time to describe all these things. If I describe you one step by step, so what our Krishna Goswami, how beautifully described here. What? So in this way, Krishnamai, internally and externally, both side Krishna. Everywhere is Krishna. Wherever your eyes is going, Krishna sings there. Antar Bahire, everywhere is Krishna. Wherever you go, find the Krishna everywhere, according to Radharani. Wherever Radharani visit, she see the Krishna only, everywhere. The Prem Vichitra. So taking darshan of Krishna Sundar and Madhurya, Radha is not satisfied. once
Krishna
Krishna entering into Kunja, and at that Kunja Radharani herself meet with Krishna, and outside Lalita and other Sakis was standing there. When Radhaji came out, and the Lalita Sakhi asking, "Hey Radhe, you took the darshan of your Pranapriti, please describe something." Radhaji crying, she is saying, "Hey Sakhi, if you ever seen my Pranapriti, please tell me, I've never seen him. How he is, where Shyam Chalona, how is he, I don't know." Lalita Devi is saying, it is all the Vitak Madhav Natak. Lalita Devi is saying, "Are Babri, oh fool, you meet with him just now. You are coming out meeting with him." Radha is saying, "I have never seen Krishna." So that's why Chandidas is saying here. Chandidas is describing, Mahakavi Chandidas is describing, "Hare Krishna darshan is so far." So when she hear the sound of Krishna, the name of Krishna, her mind is disturbed. That Shyam name is too sweet. Krishna is teda. If you take a little bit teddy vasu, what is teddy? I don't know. If you take a zigzag thing into your somewhere body, so it's not easy to take out. So there is a thorn like the zigzag form. So whenever you go to Vrijmandir Parikrama, especially at the forest, when we go there, Chhoti Baithan, for last 3 years we haven't been there. We have stopped for last 4 years there. Sheshwai Dwar. So when you enter in that forest, by the forest, so if you are going by the forest, so there are zigzag like thorn there, and the thorns, it's very small when it enters into your feet, so it's really hard to take out. So in the same way, Shyam Chalona is zigzag, teddy. It enters into somebody's heart, so you cannot take out. Ramchand is very simple, very silly, very simple. Whenever he enters somebody's heart, he can come out. Just like we put a keel into the wall and to the straight, so then you can take out it. But if that keel we put on that wall, after some time when that keel little bit teddy, little bit zigzag, so you cannot take out it. So then you cannot take out it, and then at night it can be go inside. So in this way, the Krishna is teda, is zigzag. He is teda tongue wala. Mukesh Pagal. Oh, Binod Agarwal. Wo to kala nahi hai mat kala. Yes, Ramachandra is straight, seedha, simple. Straight means simple. So you will find some this teda word in this. Our Chandidas is saying, you will find this teda word in the bhajan of Granth Agarwal. The Krishna name is teda. When it is enter by the ear, through the ear and into the heart, so then it cannot be come out. I give you the example. just like Bakura cut, the zigzag thorns when put inside your feet, you cannot take out. You have so much pain. You can see that. And you cannot take out that until it cannot come out. So your feet will be like tuck 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 tuck. And so Kanhaiya is tear tongue, is zigzag form, tribhanga form, when entering somebody's eye, somebody's heart through the ears. So he cannot come out easily. That's why Radhaji is saying. So who has tasted the Krishna name only they can understand. That's all our Rupa Goswami Pad is writing in the Vidarbhanata, the glorification of Naam. So when he heard the glories of Naam, so they were enjoying that. And Haridas Thakur himself saying in the Ved Puran Upanishad everywhere there is a glories of name we have heard. But Rupa Goswami Pad in the Vidarbhanata Grantha, so the glorification is described in the Vidarbhanata Natak. It's incredible. It's not the past nor future, na bhuto na bhavishya. Sarudama Rayaramananda and others, there are great rasik, tatvakva, marmagya, the nitya parikara of Mahaprabhu when they assemble in the court of Mahaprabhu. Just like Rayaramananda is not ordinary. Sarudamudar is not ordinary. They are both higher than others. So all the nitya parikara of, so they all were praising to Rupa Goswami Pad. In the Vidarbhanata Granth Natak, it is described everything. And there are many, many other devotees, the great devotees. And at that court, Vallabhacharya was also assembly. Vallabhacharya was also well there. So sometimes Vallabhacharya also comes to the Sabha of Mahaprabhu, assembly of Mahasabha. And when Swarup Damodar Anand described the glories of Mahaprabhu, at the time, the Vallabhacharya. He is so much intelligent. He is so much aged also. He is almost 70 years old. So, Vallabhacharya himself, so hearing the glories of Rupa Sanatan. So, Rupa Sanatan was very young that time. When Vallabhacharya heard the glories of Rupa Sanatan, so Chaitanya Charita Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is describing there. I don't want to. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is saying, when Vallabhacharya is seeing the glories of Rupa Sanatan, then Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself is describing the glories of Rupa Sanatan himself. Mahaprabhu. Sanatan Goswami is Mahapandit. Mahaprabhu praised him so much, Sanatan Goswami Pad. Especially Sanatan Goswami Pad, the famous granth is? Which one is? Stabavali. Nahi. Prahad Bhagavatam Mritam. So you cannot find the nectar, the granth like Prahad Bhagavatam Mritam. Mahaprabhu himself is saying the glorifying in the Vallabhacharya court, he is describing and praising Sanatan Goswami Pad. This Roop, look at the Roop Granth, Vidagdha Madhav, Ladit Madhav, and etc. The other Granth, Mahaprabhu himself is describing the Kirtan of Roop Sanatan. Look at Rai Ramandan, Surab Damodar. Mahaprabhu is praising one by one other devotees, and Vallabhacharya was so much astonished. Oh, what kind of devotees they are? So I'm telling you. So first I'm little describing the Vallabhacharya was thinking that I am the topmost because he was so much aged, and he was thinking that I am the topmost. I'm the topmost intelligent here. So at one time what happened? So he told to Mahaprabhu before Mahaprabhu. Topmost tikakar, the topmost tikakar of Shridhar Swami. Shridhar Swami.
He said
the Mahaprabhu, before Mahaprabhu, Shridhar Swami is belongs to Mayavadi philosophy. That's why he said, so I have rejected the tika of Shridhar Goswami. He is a Mayavadi philosopher. So Vallabhacharya himself said, because he was so much praised, he was so much pleased by hearing all the glories of the devotees of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu just said only, Mahaprabhu said the little word. Mahaprabhu just said, what Swami means, Shridhar Swami. Swami means Shridhar Swami. Shridhar Swami is just like a prostitute, as well. Ah, yes, he was describing like that. Mahaprabhu said, Krishna Name, Atubhut Hari Bol. Mahaprabhu, he is destroying the ego of Shridhar Goswami. I have never heard the Chaitanya Charitamrita is describing that. There are two names of the Krishna is famous only. In the Braj, there are two names of the Krishna is famous. First is Yashodanandan and Shyamsundar. I have never heard the meanings of Krishna except Brajinandan and Shyamsundar. Yashodanandan, just like jonk. It's a kind of insect. Jonk. When who suck the blood, it's just like an insect. Jonk. Leech. Jonk means leech. Oh, I don't know. Jonk. So whenever it puts somebody's body, so it will suck all the bloods of the body. Jonk is very, very dangerous. Jonk leech. Some mosquitoes here is like that. Whenever it puts on the body. In the morning whenever I do the Harinam, and so it's touch my body so tightly until I won't kill them, so he won't go away. I have seen my head become red because the machar was seated on my hand. Until you will not massage that mosquito, it won't go away. So what's my mean to say here? When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, so he described very nicely that I never heard the Krishna's name, many others name. There are many names of Krishna's. The only famous two is Yashodanandan and Shyamsundar. Only I have heard this. So hearing that katha, Vallabhacharya, he was so much feeling insulted. So jonk, the leech. If you want to take off the jonk, the leech from your body, so you have to put some salt on your body. Then, because it cannot tolerate the beer, jonk, the leech cannot bear. Jonk cannot bear the salt. If you put some salt, then it will go away from there. So in the same way, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he destroyed the ego of Vallabhacharya. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself described the glories of Dhrup, Sanatan, Raya, Ramananda, Swarup Damodar and their devotees. When he described all the praising all the devotees, Vallabhacharya, he was so much astonished, especially in the Bhakti Rasama Sindhu. In the Ujjal Neelmani Granth, it is the essence of Gaudiya Vaishnava. In the other sampradaya, you won't find this Granth. In a Mayavadi sampradaya, any other sampradaya will speak a lot. But if you want to speak something, if you have to attract the people, then you have to. They must read the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's written. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Priya Patra, Rupa Goswami Patra written, Bhakti Rasama Sindhu and Ujjal Neelmani. Especially in the Mahaprabhu Pasha, Rupa Prabodhananda Saraswati Path, Radha Rasa Dhanasai must, they have to recite that shlokas. Otherwise you cannot make a face in the crowd. You cannot make a face in the crowd. There was a he was reciting the shloka of Adar Sambradhar Radhu Bhagwan. Actually there was a I tell you what happened. We recently Gurudev was a disciple of Gurudev was showing katha of Adar Sampradaya, Ramananda Sampradaya. So Gurudev disciple was showing the katha of Ramananda Sampradaya. So he was describing so much Mayavadi philosophy, but at least what he said, he was reciting this shloka Aradhya Vijeshtanim. So I mean to say that if you want to make a face and if you want to make the impression in the crowd, so you have to read the Mahaprabhu's Granth, Mahaprabhu's disciples' Granth, Mahaprabhu's devotees' Granth. So who is belonging to Mahaprabhu Sampradaya? So leaving Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, you cannot find the Rasmadhura Granth in any other Sampradaya. It is not described in any other Sampradaya. The Rasmadhura is described in the Mahaprabhu Sampradaya only. I am just reading here only. I am not going deeper. So if you get one word, so it will take a lot of time. But I am just reading here and I cannot describe too much. So if you talk on one word, so in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, so for describing this one adhyay, it will take 1 year. So what is viraha? What is the separation? What our Rupa Goswami Pad is saying? What is the definition of separation? There are many kinds of definitions. At least Rupa Goswami Pad is writing there. What is the definition of separation? The tears of the eyes, wonder of the tears of the eyes is the definition of separation. An example was given too. Once Srimati Radhika, she was so much agonized in the separation mode of Krishna. I am just completing this katha, the time is going to hour, I will describe you tomorrow. Once what happened, Radhaji was so much agonized in that separation mode of Krishna. So she was thinking about remembering Krishna and the tears was coming out from the eyes at the time Lalita Sakhi came and she got understand. And Radhaji, what she is thinking. So Radhaji is saying, Lalita is saying, hey Radhe, what do you do? Do one thing. Take a write a letter to Krishna. So Lalita Devi gave a pen and more mayur feather, peacock feather, and there is a kind of fruit in the braj. So she make a ink of that fruit, and there is a bhoj patra. There is a paper like a patra she gave to her. And she was writing a letter to Krishna. She is writing a letter to Krishna as we write. Sometimes we take a hik. So Radhaji writing. She put the nip of the feather, peacock feather, in what she was thinking. She is writing a letter to Krishna. So she is remembering the Krishna. So her mind is observed too much and she is thinking that I am Krishna to Radharani. So she is writing a letter to Radharani. So Radharani is thinking that I am Krishna, writing letter to Radha. Radheko. So now, and the tears was falling down from the eyes, and all the trees, leaves of the trees, wet with the tears. Let us say, what is this incident? So she had put. So Lalita Devi dispatched that leaves to the Krishna. She tied and packed that and dispatched by the messenger to Krishna. And Krishna opened that. Only the lover's voice can understand why the beloved. Lover can understand the feelings and the voice of the lovers. And when Krishna started reading that, Krishna was so much weeping. There is a shlok, was I have forgotten now. There was a shlok. Very beautiful shlok was there. And so Krishna himself, he got fainted. Seeing that letter. that she was observing she was remembering me, and Radha ji became Krishna herself. Adbhut, Hari
Bol.
And Advaitwadi is saying that everybody became Krishna. Except the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, and other Sampradaya you will go. In other Sampradaya you will enter and think about them. So you will come to know. Only the Mahaprabhu Anukarjan have the pure devotion. And if you are coming to the Dhara of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada Dhara, except Bhakti Siddhanta Prabhupada Dhara, you won't find the pure love. You will find a little bit gandh, a little bit smell of Mayavad. It's true, you will find a little bit smell of Mayavad. Except Mahaprabhu lineage, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada lineage, or Bhakti Vinod Thakur lineage. If you are coming into the lineage of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada, so you will find the pure devotion, the pure love. Many Bhagavatkar Patak is saying we should pay respect to all Sampradaya. Samanmyavad, secularism. It's not the Samanmyavad. The true is true always. What is true? You have to establish that. Only Mahaprabhu's Vishardhara you have to establish. If you can understand, I don't want to disclose a name. If you have understand, then you can. So everywhere. So all the Sant Samajas commenting. All they are disturbed their mind. They are commenting each other. This kind of mentality is not good. We should always establish the truth. You cannot find the speaker except Mahaprabhu's dharas. Everybody, Babaji, Sakhi, Medhi, and other Sampradaya. Call everybody. That's why our Gurudev used to say, he was describing, he given a lecture of Samanyavad. I wrote Srila Gurudev Vaman Goswami Maharaj. So he was quoting the Prabhupada lectures at that time. Somebody's hand, somebody's leg, somebody's that, somebody's this. So they make a form. Sometimes you saw an idol, sometimes you saw a Kali Murti. And Vishnu's hand is there in the Kali's statue. You will see Vishnu's Padma Chakra Shankh Gada, and Kali's hand you will see Ganesh Sur, the tongue of Ganesh ji. So these all are prapanchak, these all are the pretender. These are another good devotee. Take the Kali form and put everybody's hand leg. So if you want to be the Nirvik Bhakta, if you fearless Bhakta, you have to be a speaker. You would like to be a fearless speaker. Establish all the truth. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur Prabhupada was a fearless speaker, and many people tried to attack him and kill them because he was destroying all the matas. Ramanacharya Sampradaya also, I have heard the katha of Quraysh, they want to attack them. We have heard this katha, the Shuddha Satya, always establish the Satya. Always speak the truth. So whoever is speaking the Bhagavad Katha these times, they are just making... Chachapan Pranamachav. If you speak the truth, so many people won't come. If you speak the truth, many people won't come. That's why you have to establish the truth. Become a fearless speaker. That's why the Gaudiya Sampradaya, Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, they have the Shuddha Vichardhara, pure devotion they have. So the time is over now. So Maharaj will elaborate something. So now I'm stopping my voice here. In fact, Rup Sanatan, the contribution in this world, Mahaprabhu's contribution is, Vaishishta is, our Acharya showed that. Just like Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, he showed so much beauty, he described everything beautifully. So there is no need to read other, if somebody study the Chaitanya Charitamrita, So all the granth has been studied. That's why you should study the Chaitanya Charitamrita again and again, again and again, again and again. And you will get to know the Vichardhara of Mahaprabhu Vichar and others, Mahaprabhu's Parikar Vichar. Gaur Premanande, Hari Hari Vancha Kalta. Hare Krishna, Jai Shri Gurudev. Thank you for tolerating me. Hare Krishna. Thank you.